Appropriation Bill 2016. Committee stage. Council is now in committee. There will be 8 groups of debate. The first is in relation to heads with no amendments. When it is endorsed, it will become part of the schedule, and afterwards we will have debate on second to the sixth debate. The method for grouping is in accordance with last year's arrangements, that is in relation to policy areas. After the debate and voting has finished, the committee will have a debate on the seventh debate, and afterwards the amount of the heads will be put to a vote to become part of the schedule, and then there will be stand part of the bill. First is the first and the second part. And then we will complete the scrutiny of the second of the appropriation bill, and then there will be the third reading. I estimate that we will complete all procedures on the 11th of May. In accordance with Rule 68 of the Rules of Procedure, the committee will first consider the schedule. I now propose the question to you, and that is that the sums for the following heads stand part of the schedule. Heads 26, 27, 79, 94, 95, 114, 136, 169, 174, 180, and 184. The clerk has just read out the heads with no amendment. The committee now proceeds to the first debate. Members, if you wish to speak, please press the speak button. Mr. James Toll. I speak in relation to the LCSD, the Leisure and Cultural Services Department. As you know about the National Taipei Arts University, the department asked for the name to be changed because they don't want the word national to appear. Well, when it comes to dealing with similar issues, the LCSD should have proper rules so that the public will understand the rules. In recent question asked of the Secretary for Home Affairs, the LCSD's answer is strange because they said that you can't put the blame on a particular staff member. Well, there were press reports saying that a certain staff member will have to be held responsible. There should be a proper system. When information is received, if the staff of member thinks there are problems, then the case should be referred to his superior, say for example, the director for the department, for them to make decisions. They receive a high salary, these secretaries and department heads. It may be a small matter, it is just the name, but if it's not properly handled, it will hurt the feelings of Taiwanese people, say for example in the case of the Taipei National University of the Arts. And some this is the alma mater of a lot of people, and they have a very strong feeling towards it. We give funding allocation to senior staff members. How come it will turn out like this when they go through the procedure before they make a decision? If there is indeed such a system under the LCSD if they find that it's a matter that is not allowed by the law or not allowed under a major policy. If it's not the case of the exercise of statutory powers, it's only an administrative decision, and if they don't have to make any legal considerations, then we wonder whose decision it should be, the bureau secretary or the department. And so far, after the incident, no one explained to us who made the decision. They are all hiding. Is it the case that it's a frontline staff member who has made an administrative decision, or is it someone higher up, an assistant director or the director, or is even gone above the department? Who has made the decision? And so far, there is no clear account given. And it seems that the government is trying to drag their feet as much as possible. They hope that it will go away if they don't come out to explain. We have to make sure that public money is properly used. The more senior you are, then you should have a more macro view. You should be able to take into account the situation as a whole. And the person should be able to decide whether it's the best approach. So someone high up should put in place guidelines and procedures. And if indeed it's a case involving sensitive words, then should it be a decision for a senior staff member who received a bigger salary? Shouldn't there be consistent policy? And if the government think they have made the right decision, well, then you should come out to explain your decision to the public. And so far, you pretend that nothing has happened. Ask no questions and speak nothing about it. Mr. Leung Kok Hong, there is no quorum here.
Thank you. 何俊仁議員.
Mr. Albert Ho, Mr. Deputy, although there are, there's no amendment to these heads and there's no proposal to delete any expenditure, well, I would like to remind the officers of the LCSD, be careful about your work. By this, I mean that you should follow your usual policy. You should act fairly and reasonably so that the public can enjoy the venues under your management. In the past 2 years, I've received complaints from a certain organization, and I've told the director about that. And that is, they have tried to hire your venues so that an overseas dancing troupe can give their performances. But the applications were rejected again and again, saying that no venue was available. But the applicant wanted to apply for the, some venue days a few years later, and they asked when the venue would be available, and the LCSE said that they would have to apply again. We have reasons to believe that the LCSD has received instructions saying that they would not be allowed to hire LCSD venues because I think the organizer is connected with Falun Gong. But this practice is against the policy of fairness, and it may lead to a judicial review. When the LCSD loses a judicial review case, it will not just affect the reputation of the LCSD and the government, and there will be legal costs incurred. A few years ago, the Immigration Department was taken to task for failing to issue visas to certain working personnel of an organization. And the case, in that case, the Immigration Department lost. So I will urge the LCSD to manage your venues fairly, and every applicant will be treated equally. Mr. James Toh has just said in his speech that there is also the political screening of certain titles, such as the deletion of the reference to anything called national. This is not in line with Hong Kong as an open community, and it will also hurt the feelings of our friends. Once again, I will urge the Bureau and the Department to review your policies. Don't give people the impression that we have a lot of political vetting in Hong Kong. And in a moment, I will be talking about LVHD, the Immigration Department, and the Post Office. They are all guilty of doing political censorship, and this would lead to the Hong Kong community moving not forward but backward. In accordance with Rule 40, Bracket 4, I move a motion to adjourn the proceedings. I have a question. Whether the time spent on this motion would count towards the time for debate as ruled by the President? As far as I can understand from the President's decision, the debates will be allocated time up to 50 or 60 hours, and the voting will take place on the 11th of May. So whatever happens in the interim will count towards that final deadline.
Mr. Chen Shih-chun has moved that the council now be adjourned. Mr. Chen Shih-chun, would you like to speak? I ask for a quorum count, Mr. Deputy.